thing's supposed to be some kind of autofocus, I hope it is.
How y'all got the lights off backwards? So we're gonna complete the square, and we're gonna throw a little bit of challenge into it. Because my goal is to what? Discourage you. So, x squared minus 3x minus 7 equals 0. All right, complete the square on that. But what do you do first?
Move what?
Move C. Now what? That's not rhetorical. You're supposed to interact with me.
3/2 squared.
3/2 squared. Oh, V/2 squared. I thought you said 3 over. I thought you were trying to.
Okay, forget it.
Either way.
3/2 squared. Well, what's the problem? You don't come out with a whole number. So you quit, right? Mm-hmm. Now, just darn. I just smashed one of my peanut butter M&Ms. There's two options. One is to change it into what? 1.5. The other is to leave it as 3/2. Which one do you think I'm going to get you to do?
3/2.
Why?
It's rise over up.
No, you're wrong.
Sorry, you should quit. You're such a disappointment.
Why do I want you to leave it as a fraction? Because if you change it to a decimal, what do you got to depend on? Right? Unless y'all like working with decimals in your head. Alright. So, change it to a fraction. 3 divided by 2 is 3/2. 3/2 squared is what? Let me write this out because some of y'all are going to forget. 3b divided by 2 and square it is what? 9/4, Schubert. That's right, class. You know, interaction makes the class go by faster. Did y'all know that? So I appreciate y'all's interaction. Now, what does that give you here? What's that? Shortcut number? Thank you. X minus 3/2 quantity squared is equal to 28/4 plus 9/4. X minus 3/2 quantity squared is equal to 28 plus 9 is 37/4. So over here, we've got x minus 3/2 quantity squared is equal to 37/4. Now you've got your vertex, the vertex form. If you want to write it in vertex form, I'm going to move this over a little bit. Seven plus 9/4. And vertex form would be f of x is equal to x minus 3/2 quantity squared minus 37/4. And your vertex is 3/2 comma negative 37/4. That's your vertex. Or you don't have to do this, but just bring this down as 3/2 and negative 37/4. That's your vertex. And we're going to solve x minus 3/2 quantity squared is equal to 37/4. Now solve it. What's the square root of 37?
6.1, Hubert. That's right, class. How did I get 6.1? Square root of 36 is 6, Hubert. That's right, class. Are y'all not awake or what? Y'all just not going to talk to me.
Okay.
Solve it. Alright, so take the square root. X minus 3 over 2 is equal to positive or negative 6.1 over 2. And then bring this over. Alright, what's 6.1 plus 3? What's 9 divided by 2?
4.5. Half of $9 is $4.50. Half of one is 50 cents, so that'd be 55 or whatever it comes out to be. 4.55. What's negative 6.1 plus 3? And what's half of $3.10?
$1.55?
Yep. X is equal to negative 1.55. So that's your what?
X.
X-intercepts. Your vertex. And your what? Y-intercept. Sketch it. Hurry up.
Y'all hungry? Okay, nobody's sitting.
A little.
Huh?
A little.
I didn't hear you.
Just a little.
Are
you offering to stop class?
No, I was going to send somebody to get us some biscuits. I need a volunteer. Come on. Come on up here. Let me go get my wallet. I've left my wallet in the truck. Y'all finish the problem. We'll be right back. Yeah, just come on in. Yeah, just come on out. I'll be
my friend
So I don't want to do marketing samples. So like I took it in like fourth graders and math class and they worked on fractions and I didn't realize how like bad I was at fractions until I was trying to teach someone else how to do fractions. But I guess that's something that we don't like spend a lot of time on.
No, you really don't. But then when you get older, you have like you're everything, so you have to know them.
Yeah.
But like he and I are getting the other one, and then his on Monday, his one of his little friends.
All right, I'm in a weird mood today, so I'm going to ask y'all a question. Mm-hmm. Why do you want to have a hole in your ear, like down here? Why do you want to have a big old ass hole in your ear?
You mean like an earring?
Oh, yeah, okay. Why?
I don't know.
You ain't got one, have you? All right, we'll make fun of people now. Why? I mean, first of all, it hangs a sign around your neck that says, I am weird, probably. Why do you want one?
Attention.
Huh?
Attention.
You know, people laugh at me because I say I don't make fun of people. I make fun of people that hang a sign around their neck and says make fun of me. But there's truth to that. A lot of people have dogs and carry them into the public buildings.
Why do they do that?
Because people look at them. Because people give them attention. If they bite me, I'm suing them. Because I hate dogs. And I can't carry my bull in a stop and go, or a. Why can you carry a dog in there?
That
wasn't
where the dog in the gas station.
Are you talking about like the handheld
dog? Anything. Somebody was carrying. I was somewhere yesterday, and somebody just brought their golden retriever in. And I know golden retrievers are pretty and funny and all that, but if he bites me, I'm suing him.
I know you can take him
in
Home Depot.
Huh? Just let one of them bite me. But I think the owners like for people to give them attention. I really do.
No, it's for socialization. I train dogs as well to do it. If you're a responsible owner, to socialize your dog for hook, have all the elements. Yeah, you can't do that at home. You don't have random strangers and everything.
But I feel like to walk around the neighborhood and I just like.
Yeah, that's what you walk around the neighborhood for.
Yeah, but if you don't have like random, like going into PetSmart, you have all these random dog smells as well as like different types of humans there. So that is socialization. And if you're not in a neighborhood that has a bunch of dogs and people, then.
We're talking about socialization for a dog.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's what
he Well, I need to get computer skills for my bull.
Part of behavior.
I need to get computer skills for my bull.
Well, I bring my dog in so I don't have to.
Leave him in the car, roll the windows up, and turn the heat on.
I put him in the buggy.
I'm kidding, okay?
He's a little loud. I just, like, open the thing up.
You gotta realize I hate dogs with a passion. I hate them.
He's walking. And, like, in public places, I don't really think he's... I'm not scared of everyone, but he
I do like one dog, and that's Fred on Smokey and the Bandit. That barks, like, once a year. Yeah. That's the kind of dog I like. One without vocal cords, or one that doesn't know how to bark. That's the kind of dog I like.
My dog is bark.
Other than that, I hate dogs. I'm a cat person.
See, I feel like that thing's a weird sign saying I'm weird.
What? Liking cats?
Being a cat only person.
Huh?
Yeah, being a cat only person.
Well, I got chickens.
Yeah.
I named my chickens.
I'm just weird.
Okay, so I'm weird. Okay, let me go get me a washer to put in my ear.
Dye your hair pink.
Yeah. I don't think I can dye my hair. I've done been told I shouldn't dye my hair. Yeah, and then you get it, and then you get it like this, and then it hangs down like this.
good.
Yeah, that's beautiful.
Yeah. Active.
I think we should just.
Just
quit.
I feel like my ear got caught in it.
All right, guys. What's my y-intercept? 7 or negative 7? What's my vertex? Was it negative 3/2 or 3/2?
It was 3/2.
3/2, which is 1.5. And negative what?
9.25.
Negative 9 down here somewhere, right? And what was one x-intercept? Negative 1.55? And 4.55? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Everything line up. So, domain, everybody should get, what is it?
All real numbers.
All real numbers. Range is, what was that, -9.25? Would y'all say?
Yeah.
-37.75 to infinity. Decreasing from negative infinity to -3/2. And increasing from 3/2 to what? And line of symmetry, x is equal to 3/2. Which is the only one of those five that has to do with the y-axis? Which one?
Range.
The what?
Range.
The range. The range is the only one that has to deal with the y-axis. And I'll say that about 10 times, because we're going to do about 10 of these, and I'll say that about 10 times, and y'all will, somebody will try to write these in terms of the y-axis. And I've told you 10 times, the range is the only one that has to do with the y-axis. This stuff ain't hard. All right, let's do a nerd. My goal is to build your hopes up and crash and burn. So, x squared, oops, x squared minus 5x minus 4 is equal to 0. We're going to do 3 of these, and then we're going to bump it up to something else. Is it hot in here to y'all? Now, I got y'all biscuits, but y'all gonna have to get y'all a drink now. I got 5 steak biscuits, 5 butter biscuits, 5 chicken biscuits, and 5 sausage biscuits. And if you're allergic to all that, then just go down and get you some water and drink it. It's too early. We can't go to Patron's. So, I think one day I will go to Patron's and invite all my classes. Because maybe 5 will come out of each class.
Only you buy the tequila shots.
What? I did that. I had a $200 bill one time at Patron's. Do not drink before everybody gets there.
Yeah.
My bill is $200.
Tequila shots on you. Got it.
One of my students that got pissed off at me the last couple of semesters put on, one of my students said that they put on, what is it, Rate My Professor, that I make people go eat lunch with me at the Mexican restaurant.
How long ago was this? Did they put it on there?
When was it?
It was last fall. It's not there anymore.
And I didn't even invite your class to the, that's what got me.
No, because our class is awful.
Your class was terrible.
No, it really was. Because see, it was like all dual enrollment students. So everybody was in high school. And there was like,
there was like,
all from Fresno and everybody else from Hannah.
There was a couple of girls from Westside.
Oh yeah, there was a few.
Oh yeah, they sat in the back row and made them.
Yeah, it was like the Crescent and the Westside people. And then there was me by myself.
And I hate to say it, but that made the class
awful. All my dual enrollment classes were like that.
The Hannah people made it bad.
Who's that?
Except
one
for the
guy
at the front.
Really
the guy at the front.
Oh, Austin?
Yeah, he was pretty.
Oh, no, he's really.
But they told him what to do.
Yeah.
They told him what to do.
He's
kind of
like a
fall. Miss Brown, what high school did you go to?
I went to Hannah.
Did you? Mm-hmm. No. No offense against Hannah, but why did they make it so miserable in that class? Were you in that class?
She wasn't. No, I had
just special before. Was you in that class that I had, there was a class that I had, but I had the West Side Queens. Was you in that class? There was three or four girls in there, they were the queens. That was just a quiet class. I don't want to perform class. Anything interesting happen in your class, Miss Brown? I think you were in that class. Mm-hmm. Was did it meet right down here?
No, we were over there. The lady who sits in the back that's in this class,
uh-huh.
She was for 120.
Yeah, that was a lot bad. No, that wasn't the class I'm thinking of. What are y'all talking about?
There's this one, like, I think he's like Indian or something. I don't know what he was, but he was like,
he's really wealthy and stuff, and like he would like just not do anything in your class, and then he'd come to your class and fall asleep. And I could not think of that guy's name.
I think he like always said something because he never did anything
for the class.
Like he never did his homework.
Yeah, he ended up not doing well in class and tried to tell me that he needed to do extra time on this, and I said no.
I
don't
think
of
his name.
But yeah, he went here.
That was an awful class. I mean, what
and
y'all's
that
fault?
Whole class though, like except for y'all, really.
Well, he was my English class as well, and that was the only two classes I took that semester. And it was like your class and our English class, and it was all the same people. It was excruciating.
Did they make it that miserable in the English class too?
Oh yeah, and they had Miss Garrett, and she would just get like so irritated. She wouldn't teach because like they would just talk so loud in her class. She could never teach because she'd be like, okay, that's fine. You can go home and do your homework.
That's interesting. They talked in her class, but they didn't talk in my class.
Yeah,
I
had
Miss Garrett in
the
class.
No, it was
A.
All right. Half of five? Five halves? And what's five halves squared? Twenty-five fourths?
Wow.
You're a loser. You went to Westside, right? Huh? I thought you went to Westside. I didn't know that. X minus 5 halves quantity squared is equal to 16 fourths plus 25 fourths.
This board.
You're right, only teacher that uses it.
There's no consistency whatsoever. No consistency. Everything's sporadic.
Oh well.
It's all Bush's fault. And that's x minus 5 halves quantity squared is equal to, I don't know what that is, 41 fourths. Where does it come from? You got to have a common what?
Denominator.
I was waiting for that question. That's the question I always get. I'm trying to fix this, but the board is doing everything it can. There. That's all the best I can do. All right, now, f of x is equal to x minus 5 halves quantity squared minus 41 fourths. So your vertex, if you put it in intercept form, is going to be 5 halves comma negative 41 fourths. Or you can just say x minus 5 halves quantity squared is equal to 41 fourths, and just write the opposite of both, 5 halves comma negative 41 fourths, and you get the same thing as you get over there. And then x minus 5 halves quantity